Yes, sir, we promised you a great
gorgeous George.
Pretty classy, the maker of
Timeless. The China.
WrestleMania.
Hulkamania is running wild.
Hulk Hogan, we are for you, nigga.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to WEDS SmackDown. The Road to Summerfest continues here tonight, alongside Matt Icorn.
Yes, and I'm gonna say that I'm excited to be back in commentary, and because this is SmackDown, I decided to take some precautions. I'm gonna sit in the coal mine tonight.
Oh, what a night we're gonna have! Tag team titles on the line. Ocean Jack and Danny Jeffers, can they coexist?
Also, we will see the Hardys take on. What seems to be like an interesting team that's been dominating lately.
That's right, the Chosen Warriors. We're going to start off SmackDown here tonight with Captain Charisma Christian. He's going to face Rob Van Dam here tonight.
Yeah, a great contest. I'm interested to see how Christian is going to deal with the veteran high-flying style of Rob Van Dam.
Both of these superstars are veterans. RVD has spoken out on Christian being at the top, maybe kind of jealous of Christian lately.
I did notice recently that RVD has been teaming along with Zach Starr and Kurt Angle, I believe.
That's correct.
But yeah, the thing is, if you have a problem with somebody, then deal with them yourself. Like, if you have to team with somebody to take care of somebody, that just proves your weakness. That's all I have to say.
Well, it's a Cena hate group. It's a bunch of cronies, as some hick from Marion, North Carolina would call them.
I hate to agree with a certain person, but, you know, like I said, anybody that has to find somebody to team up with is proving their weakness. And speaking of weakness here from the Rob Van Dam.
What's so wrong about this is RVD's capable of doing this himself. I'm not sure why he needs to team up.
Well, the thing Maybe is, if, like, any of these three men are fully capable of doing work on their own, but for some reason they feel the need to tip the work together.
Maybe they're just trying to make a statement.
I mean, I can definitely understand that. I've made statements in the past, so I can't say anything against that.
Well, I'm wrong. Armando Estrada has forced you into teaming with Suspect again. I'm not sure how that's going to work.
You know what? I don't want to talk about that right now. I don't want to talk about teaming up with the Suspect. I don't want to talk about past team damage gauge, any of that. Let's talk about something.
All right. And I am the voice of SmackDown, the voice of WEDF.
You do a fantastic job here. I don't think there's anybody else out there that's like you.
Here we go. A headlock by RVD. What is the strategy here for Christian and RVD? These two actually squared off at Last Resort for the World Heavyweight Championship.
You know, the thing is, as much of a high flyer as Christian can be, sometimes he's got to keep this on the ground in order to defeat RVD.
And that's what Christian did last time these two met. Maybe RVD feels like he couldn't beat Christian.
Maybe. The key for RVD especially is don't get that floss into your head. You know? Christian right now is showing some impressive work early on.
Captain Charisma in control of former world champion.
There's a nice power slam. And there's the cover. One. It's a one count. I mean, it's still very early, and these two are like we mentioned before. These two are veterans. This isn't going to be an easy contest for either man. They know this.
and know that one mistake could propel one of them to a victory.
Especially against those veteran superstars, it takes just one mistake to lose a match.
Oh, RVD with those educated feet right there.
He needs to pick the speed up of this match if he's going to continue to dominate.
And it's Christian. Oh, Christian Hurricanrana into a pin. Nice.
Only gets a one count again, I believe, but... And, RVD...
missed wildly.
Oh. I thought that would have been a mistake by Christian. Wait a minute.
This is flippy shit. Maybe taking a page out of John Morrison's book.
Maybe they've been training together. I don't know. They don't seem the kind of guy, two people that would get along, but... Another Hurricanrana. Maybe I was wrong about... Oh, wait. I was going to say, maybe I was wrong about Christian slowing this match down, but... There you see.
Oh, Christian, though. Backwards DDT.
Signature Christian move. RVD dodges a second.
Something about Christian is that he knows how to calculate when he knows what he wants to fly.
There's an old school scoop slam.
Oh, top rope. Christian, top rope. Oh, RVD gets out of the way. No one home.
Eats the canvas, and this could be the opening that RVD needs.
That one mistake.
It's hard to call a favorite in this match because it's been so back and forth. Wait a minute. Oh. Is that springboard kick?
RVD gained control, but wait a second. Oh. Counter after counter, RVD. Why?
There is the speed of Rob Van Dam, and that is what is going to earn him this win if he wins tonight.
And a moonsault.
I mean, getting right back in there with those moves. Oh, but Christian able to dodge that last one.
Now Christian has the opening hand in this matchup. He has the upper hand.
Oh, and a hard chop.
And Christian again planting RVD on the mat. Now he's going to the top rope. Maybe signaling the end.
Wait, oh! RVD got there way too quickly.
The flexibility. Wait, RVD looking to end it right now.
The 5-star frog splash out of nowhere. And that could be it. We're going to see this. 1, 2.
And 3.
And RVD gets what I call an upset victory here.
Defeating the former world heavyweight champion. I mean, if he could have done this at last resort, he could have been the world champion. Nonetheless, he picked up a huge victory.
It appears that he studied that last match. He knew exactly what he was going for. He knew exactly how to plan for it. And he got a very impressive victory here
tonight. RVD just...
Do you have to think that maybe John Cena is watching this backstage, keeping an eye out for this group?
Right, RVD would call some John Cena the Magic King of the Ring.
Wait a minute, what is he trying to
counter.
See, that is what I'm talking about, Christian. Wait, oh!
Oh, no. Look. The cronies, as we call them now, attacking Christian.
And Zack Starr, for some reason, is in a suit. Wait a minute.
Big Show! Here comes the Count John Cena Big Show!
Wow. The odds have been evened, and now they are running scared.
They want to fight another day. Big Show and John Cena wanting them to go at it right now.
Wait. Here comes the GM.
What a chaotic night. Already.
Whoa. Well, there's the GM at work. These six men will now face off at Summerfest.
What a night to start off SmackDown here tonight. And it's going to be even more electric here tonight on SmackDown as Osha Dex and Danny Jackpot will challenge the New Breed for the Tag Team Championships. Can Osha Dex and Danny Jackpot even get along?
I mean, we could...
I'm the giant around here. I will be the new Southern Heavyweight Champion. There's no way I'm gonna lose. I'm the giant around here. Now this is my first family right here.
Well, we are back from that incredible advertisement for Collision 4.
Yes, correct. Collision 4 is upon us, and Danny Jackpot, I believe, will be a part of Collision 4.
I can't confirm that or not, because I don't remember the card officially, but what I do know is that he is going to be a part of the tag team title match, which is going to take place right now. He's going to team up against... Ocean Jackson. I gotta say, this is gonna be easily the most heated, most hateful, hated rivalry in the history of WBDF.
These two have a tremendous amount of hatred for each other, and these two are gonna beat each other like two government mules at SummerFest. Ocean Jackson threw himself into a back wall when he said he could team with any partner. He said he'd team with the next partner, the person that walks into the office. That person was Danny Jackpot. Osha Dex knows he would not. He would hate to have Danny Jackpot become a Grand Slam champion.
I mean, this is very difficult for Osha Dex because, I mean, everybody knows that I've been friends, enemies, partners, all of that with Osha Dex. So, if there's anything I know about him, it's that he loves wearing gold. So the question is, what would be more important to him, wearing the gold or having Danny lose?
I'm not sure. I mean, he said he would team with any partner and win the titles, but then on the other hand, he hates Danny so much. Well, what choice will Osha Dex make?
Like I said before, this rivalry has been so... I'm not one to pass judgment on anybody, because I can do some things that probably make anybody... Even for me, the things that Osha Dex has done and said, trying to push Danny buttons, have even been a little too much in my head. I mean, and to use his own brother as ammunition was pretty low, even for me.
Yeah, that was pretty low, Osha Dex. They did not agree with those actions they had.
And I've been trying to keep neutral in this for the longest time because I've been pressing both of them. It's hard as a spectator and friends with both of them, but tonight they're going to have to find a way to put that aside, because these two men have been easily the most dominant tag team in the WBDF for the longest time.
That's right. The New Breed, the longest reigning tag team champions in history.
Who was it that they defeated way back when? It was it Lashley and Lesnar? Lashley and Lesnar, I'm sorry?
I believe so.
I tell you how far back that goes. They've been holding the titles for that long. But as I did mention before, I believe every tag team is a sign of weakness. And for me, and for the New Breed, that sign of weakness is Zack Ryder.
Well, anyway, the New Breed have held the title since July 7th, 2010.
Wow, that is an impressive amount of time.
Almost 9 months, and they've beaten all comers, even the Hardys. They will challenge the Hardys at Summerfest if they win this matchup.
And right now, we're going to see some chain grappling from Danny and Zack Starr.
Weakling, as you call him, Zack Ryder, is in huge trouble already.
Sorry, I said Zack Starr. You can see it's been a while since I've commentated, but it's okay.
I get him confused too.
But I mean, I caught him the weak link, and he seems to be panning out. I think Danny wanted to go for the tag, but obviously Oshajek didn't budge.
Maybe just trying to stare at him.
Maybe Oshajek's strategy is to weaken Danny by having Danny get beat up by the new breed. I just realized that.
That's an excellent strategy. And maybe if Danny Decker can somehow overcome the odds and get some down enough, maybe for a three count, Oshajek would tag himself in and win the titles.
I mean, it's a possibility, but right now it doesn't look like Danny. I was gonna say it doesn't look like there's anything Danny can do right now. But there's an impressive power slam.
Here's a cover.
And I can't help but look at Oshajek staring on the apron.
Just motionless.
And he has got his eyes squarely on Danny. He's not even paying attention to the new breed.
Oshajek may be looking for a cheap shot right there.
I think he was maybe going for a forced tag. We saw Danny getting in some offense, and maybe that's... Oshajek doesn't want Danny to look good.
Looking to work together. Oh, my! Huge mistake!
I mean, well, the question is, was that a mistake? I don't think it was.
I'm not really sure.
I don't think it was. I think Danny did it on purpose.
And again, here they go. You see a Nexus sign.
I don't know what to say to that. But this time the teamwork paid off. And there's another power slam by Danny Jackpot.
Danny's into it now.
Wait. As you said before, any sign of success by Danny and Oshajek is going to bring himself into the match.
Now Oshajek. Oshajek looking impressive. Can these two are actually working together?
I mean, we could actually see. We could see a new tag champion, but the new breed will not go down easily. They're the champions for a reason.
I mean, they may lose every single singles match or every tag match when the titles are not online, but they find a way to hold on to the titles when the gold is on the line. That's what's been like for the Hardy.
In
singles match. Oh, wait.
The communication is not there for this tag team, yet they still are able to be
I'm sorry, but do you think they're maybe trying to one-up each other?
I mean, this could... you know, that's what it's looking at right now. Wait, what? Ryder tried to get in the ring to help the Pope, and no success at all. And, the distraction paid off for the Pope, and now he's back in control.
That's why they are the tag team champions, and now Oshajek getting the call. Can these two work together and win the tag team title?
I mean, I think Oshajek is about to get them disqualified. I think he was real close to a disqualification.
At least he got out of the ring.
But I think it's as you said before, it's all about one-upsmanship with Danny and with Oshajek. They don't even care. It's not about winning the titles, it's about looking better than the other man.
Now a tag for Zack Ryder. May have been not real too fond of Zack Ryder, maybe not take him serious, but the fact of the matter is, him and Danera have worked together perfectly for almost a year.
Well, you know, I can't... As much as I don't give the guy credit as a singles competitor, he and Danera have definitely been a prime example of what it takes to be a good tag team. No matter what my opinion is on tag team wrestling, they are good at what they do.
Oh, look. Ryder going after Oshajek.
know if that's a smart thing to do. He should worry about the legal man. Now Danny has the opportunity to take back control, and there it is. There's just the head scissors takedown.
Maybe Ocho Dex in his mind wants to win the tag team titles.
I mean, if I were Ocho Dex personally, I would use this as an opportunity for Danny to lose. I mean, you don't want Danny to be a... If I'm
Ocho Dex, though, said he'd win with any partner. How would that look in his face if he lost?
I mean, it's all about the way he loses, though. I mean, if he walks out, then that makes a statement that, you know, it was his plan all along.
That may be right, but there's one part of Ocho Dex that wants to prove everyone that he can win with any partner, even the most hated rival of his.
Oh, there's another huge super kick. Danny has been in control for the past little bit.
Oh, Ryder halting the momentum.
Ryder going, I don't know what he's going for, but oh, countered with a DDT. And now Danny.
There you go.
I don't know what that was. I guess that's what he was going for originally.
And now Danny! Flying Chuck!
Shades of John Morrison.
Danny's trying to...
Danny is in firm control, and Ocho Dex, I don't think... I mean...
Wait, one kick KO! To the side of the head! This could be it!
Wait a minute.
Looking for the high roller. Will he connect? High roller! Connect!
And Ocho Dex is telling him to get the... to tag him in. Oh, there it is.
Ocho Dex
forced the tag again. I think he's going to steal the pin.
Ocho Dex is going to steal it.
He's going to steal the pin, take all the glory. Here's the cover.
Here it is. One, two, three.
And we have new tag team champions.
I'm in complete shock here.
I mean, this is... I don't know what we... There was no communication between the two of them. It was a one-upsmake contest. And yet somehow they still defeated one of the most dominant tag teams. WEDF history.
My mark, this could be an upset considered.
It's definitely an upset considering everything that's going on between the two of them.
There's been a few tag teams that have held the titles for longer. Legacy out for 415 days.
So you can see there that they're somehow celebrating with the belt. Clearly they're not celebrating together.
Nope. I have to agree with you on that. There's no way they're celebrating together.
You can see they're celebrating with those belts. They don't even acknowledge that they won with the other person. As far as they know, they won on their own. Now this is what it's like when worlds collide. Are you ready to go? Got some ready to go. What you gonna do, baby? Are you going with me? Got some going with you. That's the end of all time. What is it really that motivates you? The need to fly or this fear stop? Back in here comes the All-American American.
Jack Swagger.
Yes.
Jack America, as he likes to refer to himself sometimes.
Sometimes known as the Lucha Powerhouse.
Jack Swagger's been on kind of a slide lately. Yeah, ever since losing in the United States Championship, Jack Swagger has yet to regain that momentum.
I mean, this is the perfect opportunity to do that. If he can't get it done tonight, I don't know when he can get it done.
I forgot about that. Jack Swagger actually did make Mark Henry submit on United.
That's right. And, you know, I gotta say, if he can defeat Evan Bourne, then I don't have any arguments against him taking his spot in the title match. I mean, not like it's gonna matter because I'm gonna win that match anyway. But he does have a valid argument.
Summerfest, it'll be the TV championship online. El Rojo Mexico, who you can argue stole the championship and avoided Evan Bourne. The challenge will be facing you, Hurricane, Paul London, Evan Bourne, and Suspect.
You know, as much as I like finally getting an opportunity in a title, I must feel like I kind of feel, you know, robbed here. I mean, I should be going after something like the United States Championship at least, but instead I'm stuck with this group of who's and nobodies. But that's just me. Right now we do have this match going on between Evan Bourne and Jack Swagger. Two very different fighting styles once again.
I wouldn't count Evan Bourne as a nobody, though. He's quite a three-time television champion.
You know, Evan Bourne, I will say Evan Bourne is impressive, and he definitely has proven why he's held the title three times. But then you look at the rest of these people. El Rojo Mexico is just some guy that pretends to be
the coward. The coward.
Yes, exactly. And he doesn't. I mean, when something truly on the line, he does. Oh wow, what a counter by Swagger! But when something is truly on the line, he does not. He runs and fights. Paul London is some guy who likes to smoke weed. Who else is there? There's the Hurricane.
He's a druggie.
Nuff said. And then see, I don't even remember who, like, I don't even know who I'm facing, but that doesn't matter, because I'm going to win.
And then there's Suspect.
Well, okay, you know what? The Suspect and Evan Bourne is the real competition, that's what I'll say there. Because the Suspect, of course, me and him have that history. Apparently I'm being forced to tag with him, for whatever reason that is, but...
Armando Estrada's claim to provide Raw superiority to SmackDown. I'm not sure if Estrada's right in that, though, but he should know that you don't want to team with anyone.
I mean, he knows exactly what I want, and I think he's doing this on purpose, but, you know...
I mean, you've defeated, like... He had a little undefeated streak going on there until King of the Ring made an impact. I should agree, you should be facing bigger name talent.
Well, I mean, Armando Estrada right now is the man in charge, so, I mean, Unless he starts doing something that's really gonna to push my buttons, I will leave him with, you know, I'll leave him as the GM, but you know, I'll keep my eye on him. For now, I'll just win the TV champion and prove that I'm at least the best out of that group.
Well, that'll happen at Summerfest. Let's get back to this matchup. Jack Swagger says if he wins, he will take Evan Bourne's spot.
You know, no matter who wins this match, I will say that both of these men are very accomplished. But
there's a great
move by Evan Bourne. This could be the cover one, two, but there's just a two count. But Evan Bourne right now doing a great job of keeping this match fast paced.
What he's got to do, Jack Swagger is in trouble here.
Oh. Swagger's got to find a way to slow this match down.
He's got to ground him.
He's one of the best technical wrestlers here in the WEDF, and yet he's not able to do anything about that. Oh, another corkscrew.
And Bourne's. Oh, there you go.
There it is. There's the opening. Oh, wait, he's gonna go for that ankle. There it is.
What may Mark Henry tap on United? Will he do the same to Evan Bourne?
I will say, even if he doesn't tap to it, he's going to feel it, and it's going to slow him down, which is exactly what Jack Swagger wants.
Evan Bourne escapes.
It doesn't seem to affect him at all. I don't. Maybe Evan Bourne is better, much better than I thought.
Maybe because Jack Swagger has not only worked on the ankle till that point in the match. He hasn't been working out the whole match like he did with Mark Henry.
Well, that's true, but even still, the ankle lock can do some serious damage, and even then, he doesn't wait. Oh, a standing shooting star press. Now he goes to top rope.
Airborne!
Went airborne, and this could be it. Two, and Evan Bourne keeps his spot in that match regardless of what Swagger said.
And Evan Bourne gained some huge momentum heading into Summerfest.
Definitely impressed me, and I definitely took some notes. I know exactly what to look for in terms of Evan Bourne.
Actually, I stand corrected. If Evan Bourne's only a two-time champion, but if he can win at Summerfest, he would be a three-time champion.
Either way, an impressive resume by Evan Bourne. And an impressive win tonight.
And Evan Bourne, you know El Hijo Mexico's watching this match with that tower that basically dodged Evan Bourne.
I'm going to say that seeing this match, I'm glad I opted to watch this event from the pole line. There's no telling what Evan Bourne would come and try to do to me. Wait a minute. Speaking of the TV champion.
Not sure if dodging is outsmarting him, but nonetheless, he is still the champion.
Well, either way, he's gonna have to outsmart five other men in order to retain that title, and he's not going to be able to do it that easily.
Suddenly, we have no sound, no reaction whatsoever for Del Rio.
I mean, this is how it is. I mean, I can give a reaction to Tiffany, but...
Del Rio will be facing Rey Mysterio at Summerfest, but Mysterio's got to have singles action against Bobby Lashley up next.
Like I say, I'm liking a little bit the intro was a flashback of a few years ago. I like that, the blast from the past.
Mysterio actually defeated Bobby Lashley at the King of the Ring tournament. Then was screwed out by Del Rio. It's actually, this feud between Mysterio and Del Rio has gone back as far as the Raw after WrestleMania, the draft.
That's right. I believe that was when Del Rio debuted. He actually injured Mysterio, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
Set him out for several months.
Mysterio was already injured, and Del Rio decided to give Mysterio two injuries. It's all about Mexican pride in this rivalry, but Mysterio's got to take that out of his mind and try to find a way to beat the number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship, Bobby Lashley.
Lashley earned that right. He was in a fatal four-way, if I remember correctly. And this is going to be the biggest test for Dolph Ziggler since becoming champion.
See, Dolph Ziggler's defeated the likes of Jeff Hardy, a tough opponent, likes of, who else did he beat?
Defeated Ocean Jones.
Yeah, and, well, not saying this is a tough task, but he defeated Daniel Bryan. Dolph Ziggler will be facing Daniel Bryan later on tonight. If Bryan does win, the match at Summerfest will become a triple threat.
I don't see that happening, but one thing is for sure that Bobby Lashley has already earned his right to face the Intercontinental Champion, and tonight is his opportunity to prove what he can do to Ziggler in that match.
Bobby Lashley sent a message by spearing Dolph Ziggler.
I'm Ziggler, I'm watching this match right now. I'm making sure that that Lashley doesn't just tear Rey Mysterio apart, and B, you watch to see exactly what Lashley does so that you know how to counter it.
last time on Raw, SmackDown, I mean, Mysterio actually faced off against Dolph Ziggler.
Then again, if you're Rey Mysterio, or if you're Alberto Del Rio, you're also watching this match. Because even though Del Rio has been able to best Mysterio in the past at Summerfest, it's going to be one-on-one. I mean, there's no hiding or sneaking attacks. You know, it's all about getting in the ring one-on-one, and so...
It's going to be in the steel cage as well.
Absolutely. There's nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
I believe Del Rio will be in trouble. Look at Mysterio high-flying these two.
And that is what makes Mysterio so dangerous, is that high-flying ability. Oh!
Lashley dodged it, but Mysterio... Oh, Lashley couldn't dodge that. That Hurricane Rana head scissors.
Mysterio's speed is just way too much, even for Bobby Lashley, to completely dodge. But it has not countered him out yet. An impressive belly-to-belly.
Lashley the power. No, Mysterio!
Oh! Wow, what a counter.
One thing about Mysterio is he can be down and out, and he can turn nothing into something.
Oh, but Lashley there, grounding Mysterio perfectly. What an impressive spybuster.
And again.
Oh. Is he gonna... He's gonna go for the cover after that one. One. Two. Mysterio able to kick out. There's one thing Mysterio's known for. It's his fighting spirit, never give up attitude. It's actually what makes him... It's what's most dangerous about Mysterio, I believe.
And Mysterio... Look at this!
Oh.
DDT!
Oh, it's springboard splash.
Mysterio picking up the momentum of this matchup.
What is he thinking about here? Oh! And a seated senton. Goes to the cover, this could be it. Two... And another two count. Oh, whoa, what?
Lashley, tremendous flexibility.
Wow, for a big man, that is impressive. You cannot ignore that. What a suplex we have there.
Don't count Lashley out. He's one of the best pure athletes WEDF has to offer. I am
perfection. Wait, Dolph Ziggler.
Intercontinental Champion, Bobby Lashley had this match in hand.
Wait, what? Lashley, maybe you want to pay more attention to this match, maybe?
Dolph Ziggler distracting Bobby Lashley. And Lashley's paying attention to Ziggler.
Okay. Oh. Mysterio!
619 on an unaware Lashley.
And he connects completely. He's gonna steal this one. One, two.
Two and three.
Mysterio gets the victory off of that huge distraction from Dolph Ziggler. Ziggler definitely got the last words in that.
This Ziggler gets back at Lashley. It's now one up between Lashley and Ziggler.
But even still, if a win is a win, Rey Mysterio showed what Del Rio was in store for at Summerfest.
Mysterio picking up a huge victory here tonight. I believe he will defeat Del Rio at Summerfest.
I don't think there's nowhere for Del Rio to run or hide, so you gotta think that the only thing, the only possible outcome is for Mysterio to come out on top.
Why not? We've had for SmackDown already.
I mean, this has been exciting, and I'm happy that I was able to Big Baby commentary return tonight. I've seen a lot of we saw new tag champions. Summerfest is going to be exciting.
The biggest party, the biggest festival of the spring. NWO DX, the WEDF Championship match. Abyss challenging Goldberg. This is going to be huge. Basically, Abyss versus Goldberg is the unstoppable force, meaning the unstoppable, movable object. Up next, the Hardys try to look to gain momentum, hanging the Summerfest challenge, facing off against the Chosen Warriors.
It's going to be an interesting contest. More tag team wrestling.
And here comes Reckless Abandon. Wait, never mind.
Here come the Hardy Boys. If you're talking about tag team wrestling, you're talking about the best. If you're not talking about the Hardys, then you're not really, you don't know what you're talking about. Because, again, when it comes to tag team wrestling, they almost, you can say that they wrote the book on extreme tag team wrestling.
I really thought that was Reckless Abandon at first.
I can't blame them. It's the same thing. They look the same. One guy has face paint on. The only difference is that I don't know if there's anybody that's a quote unquote. What's the word that Hardy's calling himself now?
Head? Oh, yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, I've been drinking.
And here comes the Celtic Warrior.
Formerly the Celtic Warrior. Sheamus, although he hasn't really done much on his own here. I mean, Sheamus is definitely a powerful superstar. He's huge. I don't think people understand how big he is until he gets into the ring.
I mean, ever since WrestleMania, when he had that best match of the year against Goldberg, Sheamus has had to rebuild himself up. And he's found a partner similar to his style, Drew McIntyre.
Play similar to his style, you mean they're both not from America, then...
I mean, the whole bitch is in the ring, not to mention.
Here comes Drew McIntyre, who, by the way, what's sad is that Drew McIntyre gets a bigger reaction than... that same time.
That's pretty bad.
But here is Sheamus' partner tonight. They've been working together for some time. They've actually been impressive. A win tonight against the Hardys is trying to be a window to the tag team championships.
Well, Hardys will be facing Ocean Jackson Dane Jackpot. So this is probably a bigger win for the bigger match for the Hardys rather than the Chosen Warriors.
Either way, whoever wins this match is proving something tonight. Because even though the Hardys have been together for so long and they're such veterans in tag team wrestling, you can't take anything away from Sheamus and McIntyre in terms of their wrestling style and their ability and their success together.
Last time these two met. Oh,
what? That didn't make any sense. I guess Matt noticed that Jeff Hardy was maybe high or something. So he forced him out of the match.
Well, Matt Hardy has been kind of fit here tonight. Oh, at least he's not eating great.
Well, you know, the thing is, I've been a fan of Matt Hardy for a long time. So I can't really say too much against the guy.
I'm not saying anything against him, too. I'm just saying that he's got himself into shape. He wants to win those tag team titles. The Hardys want to be on top of that mountain again.
Well, you know, the interesting thing is that as successful as they've been as a tag team overall, they have the tag team championship belts have found their way to elude the Hardys ever since they've reformed here.
The New Breed have had their, you can say the New Breed might have their number, but the New Breed aren't challenging them anymore.
Well, the New Breed is out of the equation, which may be the answer that the Hardys needed. There's poetry in motion. Although I'm not sure if Jeff understood what just happened exactly. But he is in control. Or he was in control.
Oh, that belly to belly throw.
You could say it's a fella to fella suplex. Drew McIntyre now in this match. The fresh man.
You know, Drew McIntyre and Sheamus have faced the Hardys before, and they know they want to get a little amount of revenge for the Hardys beating them last time.
I mean, it would be embarrassing to lose to the same tag team twice in a row.
Sheamus has defeated Matt Hardy in singles action, though.
You know, the question I have right now that I just realized, my question is, where is Finley going to fit into this equation? Finley is at ringside coaching the other two. He's the veteran. He's been coaching these two ever since they formed. And you know, how is he going to fit into this equation? He could be the answer that they need to win.
You know? That's right. They actually formed. You remember when they attacked Abyss? Made a statement on him. It's still Abyss won. Abyss is that unstoppable monster.
I mean, you can't use Abyss to make a statement. That's just stupid. And now there's a tag. There's another tag. Matt is back in this match.
They're still attacking the undefeated monster, even though they lost.
I mean, definitely.
They want to take on anyone.
I mean, it proved their fearlessness. I'll give them that. But it also proved their stupidity.
Yeah, next time attack someone you can actually win against.
He just lifted him up with ease. That was really impressive by Matt Hardy.
Matt Hardy taking his focus off.
Wait! Counters into that DDT.
A right hand to Sheamus. And Matt Hardy's back in control. Well, for a second he was.
Oh, and a huge lariat by Drew McIntyre, the sinister Scotsman. It was a bit of a stare down. This match has been very slow and calculated. Which I would think
the Chosen Warriors are about. They like to calculate.
I was gonna say that favors the Chosen Warriors. Wait.
Side effect.
Side effect in the cover. This could be it.
One. Oh, Sheamus, right there to break it up.
Sheamus, that's the speed of Sheamus is impressive. That guy, Sheamus is like 270 some pounds, and he flew into that ring.
One thing this match favors is that this match, unlike the last one, is not a Falls Count Anywhere regular tag team match.
Oh, wait a minute. Sheamus was in that big boot.
And Matt Hardy's in the wrong corner.
The Chosen Warriors are showing what good tag team wrestling is about, and that's quick tags. You've seen them come in and out several times.
As a former tag team champion, you know, you're dug deep in the corner. What is your strategy to try to find a way to get at momentum to get to your partner?
You've got to come up with a big move that can knock your opponent out long enough for you to crawl to the other side of the ring. Because no matter how quick you can get to your partner, if they can get the tag before you, you're always going to be stuck in that corner.
Wait, there's a tag to Jeff Hardy. Speaking of that, Matt Hardy with that clothesline bulldog. Jeff Hardy's fresh.
You can see he was able to get to Jeff in time, and now Jeff trying to take control. The size advantage is imminent, but... wait, what? Damn it, Jeff. Should have dropped toe hold.
Sheamus dodged the clothesline.
Either that or Jeff... What is Jeff doing? I don't understand. Why?
But remember, Survivor of the Fittest, Jeff Hardy's crazy.
Crazy on drugs. Misses that clothesline to the back of the head.
And that punch right there. Oh, a kick to the head.
Sheamus is definitely stunned.
Oh, look at his friend. He just
killed
Sheamus.
You know, that is impressive. Hardy just lifted a man who's easily heavier than him and did it with ease.
Now Sheamus been out with trying to slow down Jeff Hardy.
What?
Let's have no...
This match has no rhyme or reason to it. It's like, all logic is lost in this match. Wait a minute! Whisper in the Wind!
Whisper in the Wind connects, and now Jeff Hardy! Oh. Look at it! Can he hit Twist of Fate? He does!
The Twist of Hate or the Twist of Fate. Wait a minute, is he gonna... I think he's gonna go for the exclamation point here. The Swanton Bomb. And... What? I don't think Jeff Hardy knows where he is.
I don't either, but anyway.
There's the cover. He could still win this anyway. Two.
Two and three.
And the Hardys get the victory on that. The Chosen Warriors lose again. I think we should start doing drug testing here in WEDF. I don't think Jeff Hardy knows where he is right now.
Nonetheless, though, they picked up the victory. That's what counts.
You can't take it away from Jeff. He hit the Twist of Fate, followed by the Swanton, followed by that springboard splash. You can see this is the end of the match. He did get the cover on the Celtic Warrior Sheamus.
This is huge momentum for the Hardys heading into Summerfest.
We see them do this at Summerfest, then they could finally win the tag team gold that they have failed to win this since being here, since reforming.
A huge momentum on the left.
You can see there, brotherly love.
Huge victory for the Hardys, and what a night this SmackDown is, and more huge matches to come later on tonight.
I don't know how we can talk tonight, to be honest. I mean, it's possible, but I don't know how we can do it.
Well, anyway, I'd like to bring out this match was signed just now. Huge main event, Kurt Angle and Zack Starr team against Big Show and John Cena in our main event. A little preview for Summerfest.
John Cena teamed up the world's largest knucklehead. Can they get it done tonight? We'll find out. That music can only mean one thing. Here comes the world heavyweight champion.
Goldberg.
Goldberg.
And he will set, he's going to be facing the eerie, disgusting, worm-crawling boogeyman here tonight.
I don't know what this whole ministry. I mean, I don't. You know, I've been trying to figure out what they're doing, why they're here. You know, half of the ministry just kind of showed up, including the Boogeyman. I don't know what's going on here, but.
Well, James Mitchell has formed this group. Maybe as a way to make an impact to the whole roster.
It makes you wonder why Abyss even bothers. I mean, Abyss hasn't lost a match since coming to WEDF. And he's done that pretty much on his own.
Like we talked about in United, Abyss doesn't even need these guys.
That's exactly what I'm thinking. Like, what is going on? Like, James Mitchell was like, it's like James Mitchell was bored or something.
The Boogeyman!
But anyway, here comes the Boogeyman, as we just heard.
I'd like to point out that James Mitchell's claim to Abyss is the uncrowned champion. Remember what happened at Royal Reckoning.
Ah, oh, that's right. I mean, either way, you know, the title rules are there for a reason, and for that he is not in the record books as a champion. But that could change at Summerfest.
Abyss didn't even lose that championship, and he kind of has a rematch clause.
Either way, there's no way anybody can argue that Abyss deserves a title match. I mean, how long has it been since he's been in the... I mean, how long has he been in the WEDF now without a single loss?
Ever since debuting at Beta Champions 2009. We took out Kane and the Undertaker the first time after he sent messages. about the whole May 19th thing.
Wait, now that I know that Boogeyman has scheduled to appear tonight, another reason I'm glad I'm sitting comfortably in the home.
James Mitchell says that Plan B is work. The first plan of trying to expose The Undertaker and Kane to be the brothers did not work out after Paul Bearer overheard it. So he decided maybe forming the ministry would be the perfect plan to take up both of Kane and The Undertaker.
I mean, this is the time. I mean even though Abyss doesn't really need it, this is the opportunity for Abyss to have the champion weakened before that huge title match at Summerfest. Right now, the Boogeyman has actually been in control, but
it's like the unstoppable force meaning the immovable object.
It's a perfect way to describe that match.
I mean, Goldberg had an undefeated streak.
That's right. You go back to the days of WCW. I'm not sure what exactly the number was, but I know it was in the hundreds, I believe.
I'm not sure how many matches he's won. I've got to maybe look the history up on that. It's got to be close to maybe 40 to 50. I mean, no one's been able to stop him. Can Goldberg actually do that? Can he hold on to his championship?
I mean, the question is I honestly don't know, but I don't see, what makes Goldberg different from Undertaker and Kane, who both have failed?
Not to mention likes of Big Show, Stone Cold, Steve Austin, Randy Orton. Oh, the list just goes on and on.
Goldberg right now making what seems to be quick work of the Boogeyman. Oh, wait, no! The Boogeyman fighting back. Knows his purpose in the ministry, I guess. Knows what he was sent here to do.
I don't think Goldberg's intimidated by the Boogeyman or those worms.
I mean, you can't be intimidated by your opponent ever. Especially as the world champion, the world heavyweight champion cannot be ever intimidated by anybody, because that's how champions are lost. Whoa!
Overpower.
There is just no way to compare the Goldberg's strength.
Or we're possibly signaling the end. Or is the Boogeyman fighting back still?
Boogeyman is surprising me in this one. I thought this would be a quick match. This would be like a tune-up for Goldberg. He'd be able to take out the Boogeyman. One less member of the ministry for him to deal with. But wait, maybe we... that neckbreaker.
Goldberg looking to put it away right now.
I think he's signaling. Yep, here it is. Nowhere for Boogeyman to hide.
The spear!
Spear!
Boogeyman might be broken in half.
Wait, he's not done. Oh shit, I know what's coming up here.
Look at the intensity of Goldberg here, of the animal known as Goldberg, the Jackhammer.
The Jackhammer, a move of pure strength. That's gonna be it. There's no way for anybody to ever kick out of a spear and then the Jackhammer. Goldberg showing what he plans on doing to Abyss at Summerfest.
Question is, can Goldberg end the streak? Can he be the one that finally beats Abyss?
In my opinion right now, if there's anybody that can do it, it's Goldberg. And if he can't do it, if Abyss becomes the World Heavyweight Champion at Summerfest, then, SmackDown is pretty fucked.
If Goldberg cannot do it, I don't think anyone will be able to defeat Abyss.
Huge statement against the Boogeyman.
And remember, Goldberg got chokeslammed by Abyss. Put him through it.
Just statement to the entire ministry by the World Heavyweight Champion. But wait a minute.
Oh, could it be?
What it? This isn't. Wait, what? Oh, come on. Not this again. Yeah, I'm with her. I'm pissed off as well. You know what WEDF needs? The Brothers of Detruction.
Oh, Goldberg says he's not going to go down with... Oh, a fist! Just a right hand knocking down Goldberg. A fist is manhandling Goldberg. Every step of the way, Abyss and Goldberg have had confrontations. Abyss has just manhandled Goldberg.
Well, Boogeyman may have lost, but the Ministry once again proves their dominance. Although, I should say, Abyss proves his dominance, because let's face it, the Ministry is essentially Abyss and those other guys. And, what's going on with the belt?
A big glitch. But Abyss, just the sheer dominance of this monster. He's no man, he's no mortal, he's immortal, he's a monster. I don't think Goldberg can do the job at SummerFest.
Well, you know, I can't lose faith.
By the way, our main event, Kurt Angle and Zack Starr team against Big Joe and John Cena.
Huge tag team match coming up right now.
No, that's main event.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought that was what the main event was right now. Wait a minute. Why is he coming out here? Why? Don't tell me he's going to have a match.
Against Dolph Ziggler.
Getting the crowd. No interest at all in what's going on right now.
I think I'm going to go to sleep right now.
You know what? In the interest of... the fans, I'm gonna go ahead and commentate this match. You can, you know, if you want to go get something to eat right now, you can do that. I'll let you know when the match is over.
Yeah.
But, you know, I'm not gonna even bother acknowledging that he exists. You people know who he is. Most of you like the guy.
How can people like the guy if he gets no reaction? Oh, speaking of reaction, Dolph Ziggler, coming up to it.
Again, this is what you call a reaction. Alberto Del Rio taking a lesson in the Intercontinental Champion. Vicky Guerrero is also coming out. I'm excited for them.
These two did face off at Last Resort with the submissions from Daniel Bryan were banned. Well, Daniel Bryan wins with a doubt, although he beat Edge, although that was a travesty.
I don't know how that happened, but either way, this is a match between a champion and a vegan.
Well, one thing is the submission stipulation was lifted, so this can prove to Dolph Ziggler if he can beat Daniel Bryan. With Bryan being able to use submissions, but I believe Dolph Ziggler will be able to beat him regardless.
Wait, what is... Who said he could do that? What is he doing? There we go.
There you go, Ziggler. Show us how it's done.
And oh my god. There's Vicky. Vicky's looking good tonight.
I agree. Taking an interest in this matchup, supporting her boyfriend, Dolph Ziggler.
Like I said, Vicky should come over here and hang out in the coal mine. She's always got an invitation. There it is. There he is. The Intercontinental Champion. Wait. What? Oh. Hanging on. There we go. Oh, yeah. That was impressive. This is why he's the champion.
And that's why Daniel Bryan is not. Although, I think I gotta be at least sort of unbiased here. That way the fans don't criticize me of being unbiased.
Well, you know what? Unlike you, I don't give a fuck what the fans think. So, you know what? I am biased. Fuck you. And look at that. Look at that suplex. That's impressive.
I still think Dolph Ziggler's going to win anyway.
You know what? Oh, giving him a lesson and giving him a taste of his own medicine.
It's nerd Daniel Bryan. I don't disrespect his abilities. He's just boring and bland, and he's a nerd. That's all he is.
You know, if I gave him a chance to show his ability, then maybe I would give an opinion on that. But I'm too busy not giving a shit about the guy to pay attention to his ability. Here's the cover by the Intercontinental Champion. Oh, but the ropes are too.
Dolph Ziggler came off a victory against Rey Mysterio. At SmackDown, he's had a lot of momentum until it was halted by Lashley. Lashley, you know, saw Dolph Ziggler coming out and distract Bobby Lashley. Bet Bobby Lashley's watching this matchup.
Lashley has to watch this matchup if he wants to know how to. Well, if he wants to know, like, what Ziggler's capable of, at least, because that's pretty much what we're going to see here. It's not like we're going to see Dolph Ziggler get beaten by anybody tonight.
Ziggler countering. The American Dragon with the... What's with the American Dragon? Why do people call him that for? I don't get it. Don't you already have the Disney cartoon?
I was about to say that exact same thing. The American Dragon was a cartoon show on the Disney Channel. What is... Are they trying to say that this guy is a Asian boy from, like, the city?
Makes no sense.
I think that that's the analogy that they're making. So from now on, Daniel Bryan is an Asian kid from the city, which, spoilers, he's Sprite. So I have solved the mystery. Thank you very much.
All right, back to this matchup. There you go, Ziggler.
There is an impressive move. You see, I don't like to call anything other than Dolph Ziggler being great.
Bryan again, he's out.
But that was an impressive move. Leg drop. Now he's just taking it.
Come on now.
Wait, isn't he touching the ropes? What does the ref think? See, yeah, he was touching the ropes. I was right. Made him let go.
Submissions aren't banned for Daniel Bryan here.
The rope breaks do exist, and the ref almost didn't call it. I don't know what the ref was looking at. What the fuck was he doing there? Wait, what?
Apparently, Daniel Bryan can teleport.
Oh, come on.
No.
That is cheating.
He's coming in the middle of the ring. Come on now.
I think Vicky should get involved. Wait, where's Vicky?
Wait, referees just... Wait, Vicky, Guerrero. Yeah!
Yeah, Vicky! Woo!
I don't want to take Vicky Guerrero.
See, this is why Vicky is so great. She is always there for the...
Daniel Bryan was about to attack her. And don't Vicky...
There it is, the finishing touch, the zigzag.
And this is it for Daniel Bryan. Good night, Becca. You're done. Nighty night.
What an impressive victory by the Intercontinental Champion. With obviously no help whatsoever.
I didn't see anything.
Hey, look, neither of us saw anything. You see there, there's the cover. Great win for the Intercontinental Champion. More momentum if he even needed it. And what better way to celebrate a win than the lovely Vicky Guerrero?
I happen to agree. Vicky Guerrero, Dolph Ziggler.
We may have to get her to come scream with me when I open the champion as well. We'll have to see about that. But the question here is that with this win, what is Lashley going to have to do? We are about back. And now, now that I have my notes correct, it is now time for the main event. Thanks.
Well, Dolph Ziggler really didn't need that match, but he won anyway.
I mean, if anything, it was a good way for Lashley to learn what to do against him.
Here comes Zack Starr. Back to the trunk.
Starr has been. I'm confused about what Starr is going on with Starr. I'm all for making an impact again, like I said before, but like, do it on your own. Starr can probably take out these guys on his own. Why is he teaming with Kurt Angle and Rob Van Dam?
I'm not sure, but maybe Zack Starr feels maybe hanging with some of the up-and-comers or the main eventers might. Maybe they're coaching him.
I mean, it's definitely a smart thing to do to learn from the veterans, but to do it this way, I don't know.
Well, Kurt Angle and John Cena have no doubt have tremendous defense. Started out with John Cena testing his number one contenders match against Kurt Angle after Angle beat Randy Orton on episode 24.
That's right. Angle has not been able to let go of that grudge ever since that moment when he lost that. I mean, he has been able to, as I remember, he hasn't won the title since.
He went after Jackpot at first.
So this is easily, I have no problem with what Angle has against John Cena. But why he wants to team up with other people, why not? The whole team thing is what escaped me. All the way up to right now, the world's largest knucklehead.
The king of the shoulder block, the Big Show.
By the way, I gotta say, for those of you who saw it, that was a lovely montage of the history of the Big Show here in the WEDF that was released a little bit ago. The man has done several
sunset flips, moonsaults.
The guy has an incredible career here in the WEDF. The question is, are we gonna see any of that tonight in this tag team match? My answer.
I'd be scared to be the person receiving that.
These fans giving him minimal reaction. But here comes the man.
Cena Nation. On their feet.
I'm cheering him. Cena is an excellent example of what it takes to do. I mean, like I said, you know, if you want something done, get it done yourself. And Cena does that.
I was Cena in the past has done the same thing that Zack Starr and Kurt Angle have done.
But I mean, if you think about,
well, he hasn't done that since.
If you think about the road to redemption for Cena, you know, he did learn from what he once was, and the fans have since been appreciative of that change. And the matchup we see here, very, I mean, this is like as mismatched as you can get.
David versus Goliath.
And Goliath with a shoulder block.
Big Show's around 7 foot plus, maybe. Zack Starr, maybe 5'10".
It's more the weight comparison. I mean, the Big Show is 480 pounds.
While Zack Starr's about 200, if that.
Yeah, Starr maybe 200 pounds. There's
300 pound weight difference.
Yeah, there's, and for some reason, why is Zack Starr trying to chain wrestle with the Big Show?
One thing you better learn is don't chain wrestle someone who's 300 pounds more than you.
Oh. John Cena getting the tag, and the strength of the two of them are being proven here tonight. Wait.
Attitude, no.
I thought he was going to go for the early attitude adjustment as well. And now Zack Starr. Now he's got to an opponent much more close to his size.
Right, John Cena's 6'1", 240.
But he is still John Cena. So,
with non-drag.
John Cena's attitude is never give up, and even though Zack Starr has the control right now, what a kick!
Self-proclaimed star of SmackDown. I'm not gonna say surprisingly. The kid can do it. He's capable of all this.
Well, you know, the thing I noticed about Zack Starr is that as impressive as he's become over the last few months, and as impressive as everything that I've seen him accomplish, the one thing that I've noticed about him is that he. Oh, wait a minute! What the fuck? What is this? What? What did? What? God damn it! What just?
What the fuck? What the fuck?
Has Kurt Angle been in Jeff Hardy's weed stash? What is going on here?
Anyway, you were saying about Zack Starr.
But I was going to say, the one thing that I've said about Zack Starr is that he, the one place that he falls short is in the big moments, in those big matches. Whether it be a title match or Money in the Bank, any opportunity that he has to really gain the opportunity to win some gold. Wait! Oh! Okay. Cena with the counter. Impressive.
Now look at John Cena. Oh, look at this! The AA!
No. Wait. Now, that time he connected, the angle slam.
This could be it.
But... A rookie mistake by a veteran wrestler.
Now a tag to Zack Starr. You're right about Zack Starr. It seems like every time the big moment happens, he just can't capitalize.
Perhaps if he were to be a determining factor in this big match tonight and in this whole situation.
Oh, wait.
Whoa.
He can snap the neck of John Cena, a standing star press. Remember, John Cena has had a broken neck before.
That's right. If there's one thing about Cena that can always come back to haunt him, it's that neck injury. A neck injury is never completely gone. It can always come back to haunt him.
Cena's actually favoring himself.
What the fuck are you doing, Cena? Zack Starr just took advantage of whatever the fuck Cena was trying to do.
Cena was trying to go for that throwback.
Well, there it is. There's a shoulder block.
Now Cena, Starr counters. Nicely executed counter, but John Cena's on the wrong corner.
What a hard chop, and here's another tag.
These two are working together real well.
And impressive teamwork, again, like you said. You know, maybe they are onto something here by working together.
Or they take out the competition, then they bring it, comes down to the two of them.
I'll say that that's probably an excellent strategy for Kurt Angle, because I believe that out of those two men, that Kurt Angle easily is the better of the two. But wait, what is? Now he brings in the Big Show. Whoa, fuck!
Oh, scary!
He just picked him up by his face.
He might be a knucklehead, but he's scary when he's in the ring.
You know, I've never denied Big Show's ability and strength in the ring.
Oh wow, that's 500 pounds nearly falling on you.
Good God! I mean, he makes me look small. That's how big the Big Show is. He's probably the one superstar here in the WEDF that can do that.
Not many. And hey, you look small up, but Big Show is that one man that can... Oh, wow!
Big Show, surprisingly... he's pretty quick for a 500-pound guy.
Oh, my! Choke slam!
Oh, a huge choke slam... goes for the cover. Angle grabs the rope. You know, Big Show's also been around for a while. He's a veteran in the wrestling business. He should have known. Wait, what the?
Angle slam! He did it! He hit the angle slam!
500-pound man! What?
Angle never ceases to amaze me. And Zach Starr at Hurricanrana!
Wow. Is he going to end it here? What? Oh, 450.
Oh, Zach's only getting... Oh, no!
Wow. Big Show gets the knees up. But look... Let me refresh what just happened. Big Show got angle slammed. Now that Cena's in the ring and he is feeling it, the C Nation is behind him.
He had to make the tag to John Cena. He suffered quite a bit of punishment.
Angle slam could have ended it, but wait a minute. I think this might be it.
Time for a little five knuckle yes. Shuffle.
You can't see me, Cena.
There it is. Cena's still hurting from those attacks, the assaults earlier.
No, again with the counter. Wow. Give Starr some credit. Wait a minute.
Zach, sure you still credit. Oh, this could be a huge upset. This could be a huge upset.
Could they even mention him here? Two? What a win for both of these men. They proved everything to him. I mean, this replay will probably tell all. You can see here, the team with both of these men was impressive. I thought that the final struggle that it was going to be, that was the end.
That's tough. Give him some credit. He
look at this here. Oh, even in the this is such a. I'm shocked by the result of this. I am shocked.
Oh, it's possibly the hugest win in his career.
This is a huge moment, but again, he's got to find a way to make that happen. In a big match.
Well, that happened at Summerfest. Well, thanks for joining us for Fright Dog.
I am Homer. I'm happy to be back. Hopefully, I can do this again.
We will see you on an old school edition of Raw.